You're a human. I draw comfort by the fact that Adam alayhi salam, the first of our species, was told by Allah not to do certain things. A few days ago, my son asks me, you know what? Someone asks, what's the reason that Allah created pigs if pigs are haram? Good question, right? Why is it haram? I said, Allah wants to test you addition and subtraction. That's a simple answer. That you know what? He'll do things that, okay, you can have this and you cannot have this. He wants to see, are you going to do this for my sake? And are you going to abstain from this for my sake? So he's testing you both sides. When you go to a mathematics test, they're not going to teach you, they're not going to ask you addition only, but division and subtraction is part of mathematics. Why do they teach you subtraction if you're, you know, if you're learning mathematics? Well, because you need to know it. Same applies. When Allah says something, do something, you get a reward for doing it. He wants to reward you for not doing something, so He tells you, right, I'm going to make certain things and I'm going to tell you, don't do this. They're going to be there. You achieve a different joy spiritually when you abstain from things Allah's told you not to do. There is a different type of a blessing that you achieve. Growth of a different nature altogether. So subhanallah, Allah's made the pig not for you to be unkind or abusive or hurtful towards the pig, but rather to abstain respectfully. I'm not going to associate and eat the meat of and so on, but I'm not just going to go around and throw stones at pigs. Not at all. I'm not going to be unkind to the pigs. Not at all. So Allah Almighty wants us to do certain things and not to do certain things. That's the test. May Allah Almighty grant us goodness.